Brothers and sisters, on the first Sunday of the month, we would have regularly celebrated Holy Communion as a body gathered before the table of the Lord. But as our brother Zerming has mentioned, here we see no body. And I mean that literally. And it is a very sad state of affairs. And as such, the pastoral team has decided that during the state when the body is unable to be present in some way or form, to suspend Holy Communion until we can so gather and do it together. If you wish more explanation on that, you can go to our webpage and there's a full write-up on the front page. But in place of communion, we have decided that we would like to do a lament, a time that we take to mourn, weep at the state of affairs that this virus has caused, and even to confess our sins, knowing that the brokenness of the world is ultimately attributed to every human sin. So would you join me in a lament? Can I ask all of you, wherever you are, to stand once again and to follow on screen. There will be parts that I as the leader will say and other parts for you to respond wherever you are. This is from Psalm 13. How long, O Lord, will you forget me forever? How long will you hide your face from me? How long must I take counsel in my soul and have sorrow in my heart all the day? How long shall my enemy be exalted over me?
How long, O Lord?
Lord, our Lord, we feel miserable, frustrated, and forgotten. This COVID-19 pandemic makes us sick. It rips apart our body. It forces us from our practices. It silences our singing. It shakens our faith. We feel alone in quarantine. And when unable to commune with you and your people around your table, how long must this persist?
Have mercy on us, O Lord.
Consider and answer me. O Lord my God, light up my eyes, lest I sleep the sleep of death. Lest my enemies say, I have prevailed over him. Lest my foes rejoice, because I am shaken.
We beseech you to hear us, O Lord.
Consider us, O Lord. Answer us, O Lord. We know we are but dust. We deserve nothing but death. But Lord, do not let your enemies triumph. And do not let the ungodly disparage your good name. Brothers and sisters, I ask, wherever you are again, just to take a moment, 1 or 2 minutes in silence, and confess your sins to the Lord and cry out to him and ask him for his mercy. Let us do this in silence. But I have trusted in your steadfast love. My heart shall rejoice in your salvation. I will sing to the Lord because he has dealt bountifully with me.
We trust in you, O Lord.
Even in our darkest moment, we hope in your salvation. We long to sing praise, to celebrate your victory, and to sense your presence around the table once again.
But for now,
we trust in your goodness and your timing, because of who you are and what you have done and what you have promised. Through our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Please be seated.